Hi, I'm Kate with RGG EDU, and I'm going to show you how to install and run the Midnight Action. So first of all, if you've never used Actions before, there are a couple ways to get to our Actions panel, and one is to go over to the side here and click this play button, and you'll notice our Actions panel opens. Alternatively, we can go up to Window and drop down to Actions, and that will also open our Actions panel. Now you'll see that nothing is loaded into the panel right now, so we have to load our actions, and to do that, we're going to click our tab up here and go down to Load Actions. Now I have all of my actions saved in a folder on my desktop. If you've just downloaded the actions, they'll be in your download folder. You can bring them to any folder you'd like, just as long as you know where they are and keep them organized. I will go and click on my Midnight Action here and select Open. And you'll notice now that we have our set uploaded into the actions folder. And if we expand this and hit our Midnight Action down here, we can press Play. And there we have our action loaded. Let's take a look at the Midnight Action and see how it's affecting our image here. We're gonna notice a couple of things when we turn on our action. The first thing you'll probably notice is that we brought the entire scene's luminosity down. When we start initially, it's fairly bright, and we've sort of made it look like it's now nighttime. In addition to this, we've also brought in a lot of blues to the scene, particularly into the shadows. Now let's take this action and break it down for you a little bit. I'm gonna expand our action panel here, and you can see it's built up with a number of layers. This particular action is kind of grouped into a couple different sections here. Our first one here is our nighttime effect. This is the one that's doing the bulk of the work from the luminosity perspective. When we turn it back on, you're gonna see the whole scene is darkening. We're getting a little bit of the blue tones into the shadows. Next is our increased saturation. So this is gonna add a lot of saturation to the image. We can see that the blues are really gonna pop now. And you'll also see that if we have some orange tones in the image, like in the cabinetry of this particular shot or in her dress, those are also gonna really pop. This is really nice if you have that kind of orange-blue contrast for a beautiful complementary effect. You'll also notice that if we go into these groups, each of the individual layers are labeled according to what they're doing in the image. So for instance, if I want to come in and affect certain parts of the image, and maybe I want to decrease the saturation a bit, I can come in and toggle this on and off. And I know based on what that layer is called, how it's going to affect the image. So if you're not necessarily comfortable with curves layers or how to use them, it's okay. These are all going to be pretty self-explanatory. Now let's take a look at a studio shot here and run our action. We've kind of got these neutral tones to start, so when you see the action finally go into effect, now we have a lot of those beautiful, rich blue tones in the neutrals. And you'll also see, because we've desaturated with our desaturation group here, that her skin tone is going to this really ethereal, beautiful, neutral color palette. So for studio images, I quite like this particular action. So this action isn't necessarily great for anything that already has a lot of warmth to it. So if you've got a nice afternoon sunlight shot or something that you want to keep really warm in tone, it's not going to be the best for that. However, if you have something that you want to really give that nice, moody, cool tone to, like the studio image, or something that you want to give that sort of day to night effect, this is a really great action for that.